before we get started in this episode, just want to say a few hellos and a few thank yous. A big thank you to all the subscribers and everybody who's commented. You've made some fantastic comments and some very, very complimentary comments as well. So a big thank you for that. Want to say hello to Max Cuts, Quality Haircuts in Bedworth. Thank you for subscribing. And a big hello to Anna, who's new to the whole canal thing, has just subscribed and she's watching the video. So hello to you and welcome. Right, in the last episode, I mentioned that I might have made a mistake. Well, a lot of people speculated that it could have been the shower. It could have been some of the work I'd done, as if that would happen. I wouldn't tell you anyway. No, what I might have done is inadvertently, accidentally arranged a trip for me and my colleagues from work. And then the sun goes in to sort of dramatise the whole event. But six engineers and a boat full of beer, what could possibly go wrong, eh? A couple of people have mentioned the fuel usage on the boat when I went on my big trip, and it's something I didn't address. So I'm going to go and pick up the crew, and in the meantime, let's have a look at how much fuel I used. Well, one of the things I was quite interested in was fuel usage. What I needed to do is find out exactly what I used over 8 days. So I dipped the tank about halfway and I found out I had plenty of fuel left. But now I've finished the journey, we'll dip the tank and find out what we had left. Now I've measured the tank, it's actually 12 inches deep, and I've put a cut mark in on my dipstick, yeah, old technology, on my dipstick at 12 inches. So I'll dip the tank and find out how much I've got left. Well, I don't know if you can see that. I'll rest that on there. The cut mark is there. The bottom of the dipstick is there. And my diesel dip line is there, which is approximately half a tank. So I've done 8 days on an average of about 9 hours running a day for half a tank. Now I figure out this tank is round about 100 litres of fuel. So I've done that on 50 litres of fuel. Now I'll work that out in a bit. The clever amongst you, the mathematicians, will have worked it out straight away. We'll find out what that was a day, and hopefully we'll get that down to what it was an hour. Right, I've picked the crew up. I'll introduce them. We've got Dangerous Dave. Not quite so Dangerous Dave.
Wow.
And not dangerous at all, Ash. They've all been drinking heavily since we started.
Fine. You can drink on a boat. That's what they want.
I fear the worst. I really do. Dropped off, just me on my own now, just got to go wind, turn round, come back on my own, no great hurry, the sun's out, it's a much nicer day today than it was yesterday, though the weather did hold out, that was good. So nothing else to do than just have a leisurely cruise back to the marina and enjoy the day. Thank you. coming out of New Bolt Tunnel again now, and on the way in I ran into a boat coming the other way, but they didn't fancy passing in the tunnel. I'm not too sure whether you can, it does look wide enough to do it, but they didn't fancy it at all. Forced me, actually when I was in the tunnel, to reverse back out again. So yeah, maybe it was probably best I did that, but yeah, I'm not really sure you needed to in that particular tunnel. But it's all part of learning, isn't it? Well, the trip with the guys from work was a great success, and they're talking about making it an annual event. We'll have to see, eh? It did go rather well though, and we had a great day doing it. It's just another dimension to owning a boat, you know. You can take friends out for a day, you can go on holiday with it, you can live on it, you can do whatever you want with these things. It's really good. And they started off like party animals, drinking beer and telling jokes, and after a little while, not that long, they settled down and got into like the canal way of life, and it was relaxing and enjoyable. It has that effect on people. So yeah, one or two of them maybe even consider hiring a boat in the future and going off on their own, who knows. But it's just one man and his boat now, and probably a 6 or 7 hour journey back to the marina, and it's a cool morning, but it's nice, it's really nice. Is the boat of the owner of Springwood Haven. He's brought it down here up against a huge great crane to have it lifted out to go onto the river. So good luck with that, Adrian. And I can only imagine how difficult it was to get through some of the narrow bridges to get it here. But if I can find a spot, I might just moor up and I'll come and have a watch. But if not, I wish him all the best with that one. Well, that's another trip over and done with the guys from work, and it was a great success. We're talking about making it an annual event now, so something to look forward to every year. Also, the trip back, brilliant. Even a couple of rain showers didn't spoil it. A lot happened, mind. There's boats everywhere. Has anybody else noticed how many boats there are on the canals at the moment? And there's fishermen absolutely everywhere. And on the way back, just by Starline boats, I got waved down and told to slow down and stop because a chap had fallen in the canal and he needed to just fish him out. But yeah, it all happened. I've really enjoyed it. Just cruising along on my own, it's great. Also, before I forget, a chap came past the marina a few days ago, sounded his horn, and when I came out to see what all the fuss was about, he was waving at me. He was there with his wife, waving at me, but he was saying, "Am I Steve?" Now he's either got the right marina and the wrong name, or the right name and the wrong marina. But if that was you, just mention that in comments, all right? So just to clear up that mystery. So yeah, we'll head back to the marina, we'll park the boat up, and then look into doing more work on the boat, and there's some more trips coming as well. So in the meantime, take care, and I'll see you soon.